another ID card. For a cartographer.
Entry day plus 51. Northmore has ordered an all-hands search for objects similar to the service weapon. He claims there are more in the house, though I don't see how he's so certain. He's been strange lately, talking about joining greater causes and frequently mentioning the pyramid. After pressing him, he finally described this pyramid to me. Inverted, black, mathematically perfect. Oddly enough, Adam and the other id have shown me numerous inverted triangles painted on the cave walls. Surely there's a connection. But I don't see it yet. As far as occult symbols go, triangles are by no means rare. Flood, Levi, Kroll, they used that shape like it was going out of fashion. Standing on their base, triangles signify stability and strength. Inverted on their points, they represent conflict and stagnation. Of course, the orientation is just a matter of perspective. Looking at the pyramid from below gives you one, from above, another. Northmore says he looks up at the inverted pyramid. I have to wonder, is anyone standing over it, looking down?
Another one of those ID cards. Security chief.
Entry day plus 51. Northmore has ordered an all hands.
worst I've ever seen. Is take the nail. End of the...
I snuck into the Foundation through a back door I know. Had to get ahead of the hiss. Just a matter of bypassing the ritual protections. Luckily, the board's as distracted as the rest of the Bureau. I had to put on a brave face up there. But the situation is the worst I've ever seen. We're getting back on our feet, but we've already lost so much. Trench is dead. Darling is... somewhere. I'm the only one left. But I still have a job to do. Keep the hiss back. There's not enough HRAs to spare, so I'll have to make do with what I've got. Frankly, I don't even know what will happen if the hiss take the nail. Trench made it sound like it'd be the end of the world. He was never one to exaggerate. Well, orders are orders, even if they come from a dead man.
So I can't let the hiss take the nail. Not a problem. I know how to handle them.
Another etching.
Going on? Wait, I'm back here? Former. Yeah, we've had our differences. But it is giving me something you won't. What I can't slash, can't have. I'm getting pretty tired of being jerked around the astral plane. If you're listening, I want some answers!
See a thing. Maybe I should have thought this through. Light. Another TV. Dark. How am I supposed to drag this thing out of here? Fine, Jesse. You're okay. Just don't drop the TV. Thank you. the way out. Up there. Back at the cell. Thank God.
I know you'll take care of this, Director. I'm not worried.
Jesse, you're back. So did you find anything noteworthy? The original Bureau expedition down here left so much interesting stuff behind.
Like their ID cards. I picked up a weird one. It's pretty old.
Oh wow, look at that. Yeah, I found a few ID cards myself. Or more accurately, the Rangers found them for me.
Are you starting a collection?
I'm going for the whole set. I kid, of course. But I suppose they are sort of like baseball cards, except for Bureau stuff from the 60s. Hey, the one you found is different than mine. It looks like it's a higher clearance level.
A rare one, then. Want to keep it, Emily?
Yeah, I absolutely do. But I think you should hang on to it for now. High clearance access might come in handy.
Sounds like you have something in mind.
Guilty. See, I've been going through Dr. Ash's notes, or the ones I can find, anyway. Like Darling, he seemed to enjoy hiding his most relevant research. From what I gather, there is another floor beneath the warehouse with a special lab that requires 5 high-level staff members just to access. Here, take this. It's an old skeleton key. Something else the Rangers found. I give them $5 for every useful trinket they bring me.
I'm gonna assume this key is my ticket to that lower floor. And that super secret lab you mentioned.
Bingo bango, as Dr. Darling used to say. Well, keep your eyes peeled for more ID cards around the warehouse. If Ash's notes are reliable, and I'm sure they are, then 5 is the magic number. Don't be a stranger.
Should I be listening to? Either it could be A or B. Or neither. Let's just... The Bureau's in danger. We know we need to repair the nail. The astral plane won't break reality on my watch. hiss in the astral plane?
That didn't go so well.
The Bureau does not have windows. If you notice a window, immediately close your eyes and make your way to the nearest safe room. You are permitted to fashion a blindfold from an article of clothing. Any resulting lapse in dress code will be excused. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you. Thank you.
sure changed their tune all of a sudden. I'm overthinking this whole board former thing. They can sort out their own business so long as it doesn't get in my way. Obsessing over these problems is something Trench would do. But I've got my intuition. And you. This ID card was for an excavation engineer. Why did so many people abandon their carts down here? From the layer of dust on this place, nobody swept here in years. Not even Ati. No way he'd stand for this. There's an elevator, which I'm sure is super safe, and a space in each terminal for an ID card. Which card goes where? That's a lot of maps. One of the cards was for an excavation engineer. I wonder which console was theirs. Worked. Now I just have to get on a rickety elevator that goes who knows how far down. Dust. Still, this lab's way tidier than any of the Darklands. Why would they need such a heavy door down here? This looks like the nail, only mini. A document. Is this in some kind of code? Can't read a word of... it. I should take this back to Emily and tell her I got into Ash's secret lab.
if it isn't my favorite director. I found Ash's secret lab. Excellent. Please tell me everything. Spare no details.
Well, there was another cave. The walls were covered in paintings of eyeballs. The research seemed dedicated to studying a kinda smaller version of the nail. It looked like the same material as the one up here, but just a different shape.
Well, are you sure you didn't see any functioning prototypes? Or at least some schematics? I mean, Dr. Ash was a very accomplished engineer.
None. Sorry. I did find this handwritten note.
Wow. Ash had terrible handwriting. Never meet your heroes, right? So it looks like a transcribed conversation between Ash and someone named F. Ooh. Oh, this is juicy. This'll take me days to parse out. Maybe weeks.
Have you ever thought about taking a vacation, Emily?
Are you kidding? This is my vacation, Jessie.